these celebrations, which I've heard about for many years, let me also say how glad I am to be present in the symbolic shadow of a great African artist, Fela Kuti, in whose memory we are gathered here today. Let me also say how glad I am to be present here in Nigeria. Nigeria is a country that I've been familiar with for a long time. I remember so very vividly in my very young days as a Form 1 student in Nairobi, Kenya. My English book was written by a great Nigerian, Ogundipe. I also remember so very vividly that when I first ventured into literature, it was the writings of Eleki Amadi, Flora Nwapa, Cyprian Ekwensi, Wole Soyinka, and of course, Chinua Achebe, that introduced me into African literature. There is a sense, therefore, in which we have been familiar with Nigeria. And of course, when we started learning about history, I remember so very vividly in the political arena, great names from Nigeria, such as Nnamdi Azikiwe, Abubakar Tafawa Balewa, the Saudana of Sokoto, Sahmadu Bello. Later in time, of course, I got introduced to such great names as Chief Obafemi Awolowo. I then became familiar with MKO Abiola. And during the Civil War, whether we liked it or not, the difficult moments of Yakubu Gowon and Dim Chukwuemeka Odumegwujuku. Subsequently, of course, I've been familiar with Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, and even your current president and his stoic lifestyle, Muhammadu Buhari. There is a sense in which Nigeria has been great in many ways. And therefore, to be present with you here to talk about Pan-Africanism in the context of celebrating Fela Kuti is to be in the presence of greatness. Many young people today interrogate and ask questions about the Pan-African project. Many young Africans who are unfamiliar with the history of Africa and unfamiliar with the history of Pan-Africanism ask the question, Pan-Africanism for what? And Pan-Africanism for whom? What they forget is that this continent has had her moments of greatness. But as much as we celebrate history, we must ask ourselves, where have we come from? And Pan-Africanism can be divided into several epochs. Those of you who are a little older will remember the pioneering works of individuals such as Marcus Garvey of Jamaica. You'll remember the activities of individuals such as W.E.B. Du Bois. And you'll remember that is in those early days when all African countries were under the colonial yoke, excluding, of course, Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Ethiopia, then known as Abyssinia. It is the activities of Africans in the diaspora that served to energize the early freedom fighters such as Ghana's Kwame Nkrumah, Mali's Modibo Keita, Guinea-Bissau's Amilcar Cabral, Jomo Kenyatta of Kenya, Haile Selassie of Ethiopia, and of course Julius Kambarage Nyerere of Tanzania.